Hey girls, Maria Menounos here, author of The Every Girl's Guide to Life. Want to know my best tips and secrets for organization, travel, weight loss, beauty, fashion, and everything else in between? Go to bing.com/Maria and pick up my new book, The Every Girl's Guide to Life.
You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web and your number one source for after-show entertainment. From the AfterBuzz studios in Los Angeles, California, this is AfterBuzz TV for Celebrity Apprentice. Tonight's host is AJ Jolivette. Joining AJ will be AfterBuzz co-hosts Michelle Macedo and Phil Svitek. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest Celebrity Apprentice news and gossip. If you'd like to buzz in on tonight's show, you can buzz us at 424-256-1729. That's 424-256-1729. And now, picking up where the show leaves off, and the buzz continues, AJ Jolivette!
All right. Welcome everyone back to another episode of AfterBuzz with Celebrity Apprentice. I want to say that we have one more co-host. My favorite counterpoint, Courtney Stewart, is also...
Counterpoint? What is that?
And can I just continue? Thank you. That was only as a step in. And then
counterpoint.
And then I can continue. Okay.
You should have said your favorite human being on earth after your mom.
That wouldn't have necessarily been the truth. All right. Okay. So anyway, we are going to cover...
Well, speaking of co-hosts, Daphne is still not with us. She's still away on business, but she will be back. We promise.
Working hard.
And as you guys heard, Maria's book comes out Tuesday. So be sure to check it out. She's our network head. And more importantly, she's our friend, right, Courtney?
Every girl's guide to life. Everything you ever needed to know about being an
organized girl. Where's AJ?
Girl.
AJ's in this book.
Yes, he is.
Unfortunately.
Where are you at? Why is that unfortunate?
Because it's like you just fell in.
Because somebody thinks he's brilliant. You think I don't know why.
Hold on. How do you fall into a book?
Like the way that you did.
I think there's a whole process about creating a book.
You fell into the publishing of the book.
You're right. You know what? That's my bad. I was walking in and bam, I fell and now I'm landed in the book.
Where's it in the beginning?
It is in the beginning. Here we go.
You can't find it.
No. Hold on. AJ has great
Actually,
tips
I read
on computers.
I read the part that's quoting you.
I don't know where.
Something about computers.
Oh, it says ask AJ. For those of you watching on Ustream,
you can see
right there.
Ask AJ how to work on your computer.
So AJ is quite the celebrity on his own right.
A rooster shirt.
We got to get him on Celebrity Apprentice next year.
Ooh, got to be a celebrity first, I think.
You're in a book, brother.
You're a celebrity in AfterBuzz.
Yeah, now you're in a book.
There you go.
And by the way, Celebrity Apprentice was the number one show on iTunes. Now it's gone second to Glee, apparently.
That's only briefly. Yeah. After we post this one, we'll be right back.
We'll be right back at the top.
And RuPaul's Drag Race. In third. Surprising.
Third place, baby, because we're wonderful.
That's so interesting. We're trying to get a special guest show. In. Courtney does that one. Yeah, we're trying to get a special guest in for tomorrow night.
And we want queens. So if you're a queen out there and you want to come visit us on
Monday
night.
We have Randall Malone. Film star
Randall Malone.
Oh, Randall.
Wait, when is this one?
Tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night, 11:30.
Do you guys need another person sitting in at all? I could just sit in a corner and listen and not make a sound if I can just witness the whole.
Yeah, fuck, I'm watching that episode.
Yeah, don't make a sound.
Did you just drop the F-bomb?
Ooh. Yeah, the network is trying to avoid the F-bomb.
In my native language.
She's Indian.
It means great.
It means great. Okay, that makes total sense. Anyway, eventually.
Cultural differences, obviously.
There are a few. I know a lot of cultures who use the F-bomb. Atlanta's one, if you listen to.
Yes.
That is not the case. Stop hating on Atlanta.
I was actually just commenting on some of the colorful ways Nene chooses to express herself, especially when she's talking about other people on her team who she may or may not believe is a positive figure to do one thing or another thing, or if she just wants to beat her down, which I wasn't sure which was the case, but I'm leaning towards beat her down. That's all I meant. Okay.
That has nothing to do with Atlanta.
Well, before we fully get into the episode, let me trip up AJ one more time.
Mm-hmm.
For some of you out there, you guys are still asking where you can listen to AfterBuzz and how you can tune in.
I would like to know.
It's very simple. You can listen to us on iTunes, and you can subscribe so you automatically get the latest downloads of the show.
Go to podcasts.
Yeah, you go to. It
took me a second.
You go to the iTunes Store. Mm-hmm. There's iTunes, and then there's the iTunes Store. So you go to the iTunes Store and just do a search for AfterBuzz TV, and you'll see all the shows that we cover
under the podcast section.
No, you could just type in the regular thing.
Oh, okay.
But thanks.
Are you sure
but
that
it
works?
Was easier
because I had to go under podcasts.
You don't have to.
It just got confusing.
I couldn't find it.
You can.
I'm just clarifying.
Thank you. So go into the iTunes store of iTunes and go to the podcast section and type in AfterBuzz TV, and you'll see us. And you'll see all the wonderful shows that we do. Two, you can download a wonderful app called Stitcher for your iPhone, BlackBerry, or Android. And it's kind of like Pandora, but for your smartphone.
Ooh, exciting.
And it's mainly used for podcasts. Right, do that.
It's an interesting app. I like it.
It is. Yeah. Well, speaking of apps, we are also developing our own iPhone app coming out with the first build in about 8 weeks. Don't hold us fully to that, but, you know, we're ambitious. Of course, there's our website, so you can get our latest stuff there. And for live listening, go to ustream.tv/AfterBuzzTV. Whether it's audio versions or the video versions, such as this one, we're always going to be there live with our shows. Anyway, picking up where I don't stop, AJ Jolivette.
So, as usual, we're going to cover this show. We're going to cover what their project was. We're going to talk about the ladies' team. We're going to talk about the guy team. We're going to talk about some of the conflicts on the lady team, which there always are some. And then we're going to talk about exactly what went wrong on both teams, not just on the losing team, because there were some problems there. From all angles. As a matter of fact, in some cases, there were problems if you closed your eyes, stood in a corner, and put your fingers in your ear. There were still problems that were obvious on both teams. So I want to go over that.
So where do we start?
We start with what the theme was. Okay, so they had a project about Australian gold. I got that right?
Yes.
Australian gold. They had a booth. I can't remember the size of the booth, but they needed to advertise the product, and important factors were creativity, marketing, and branding. Let's talk about that last one a little bit. Branding, right? The branding was the koala.
Koala. Wasn't it Sydney the surfing koala?
Sydney the surfing koala. Okay, so that was branding. So that was the project, and then the two teams, they set out to go get this done. Now the team leaders were
LaToya
Jackson on the lady team, and
hold
on the
LaToya Jackson.
No,
that's good. That sounds like it.
That's great.
Hey, I love LaToya.
And our team, it was
Mark McGrath.
Okay, so Mark,
biggest idiot on the planet.
He is not the biggest idiot on the planet.
Biggest idiot on Celebrity Apprentice.
Okay, so let me say one thing. Okay, yeah, it wasn't that smart.
Well, before we talk about that bad decision.
The only reason it wasn't that smart is because it's something that you said a couple shows ago, and that is the fact that the guys are all buddy-buddy. They got this code of honor that it can actually bite them in the butt. That's what happened this time. It bit them in the butt. They have this code of honor that they were following, and actually Meatloaf said it himself. You know, we always throw...
Did it bite them in the butt?
No, it bit them in the butt, and I'll be happy to explain why if you want... Yeah. Anyway,
he's just stupid. Like,
no,
he's
not just
stupid.
He had
two examples of that being a bad plan. Okay, we're not talking about that right now.
He actually tried to take it. We'll get
that. That is the climax of the show, of our show and their show.
Okay.
Yeah,
we'll get there, Courtney.
Yeah, it's okay. We'll get there.
I'm sorry, it's so annoying.
Okay, so let's start. Since you're so interested to discuss and converse, we'll start with the lady side. Okay, so on the lady side, we've got the beautiful and talented LaToya Jackson. She is the team leader. She's good
and polite. She is the sweetest, so most polite lady.
Yeah.
For all the strangeness that there is about her, she is polite.
And her family.
And
in the words of Sammy from the Jersey Shore, she is the sweetest bitch you'll ever meet.
I'm sorry, I didn't see the...
Please don't use Sammy as an example.
Did you say strangeness? Oh. I didn't see any strange.
I'm talking about...
About LaToya.
I didn't see the strangeness.
LaToya's ensembles are strange enough.
Yeah, oh my God, I know.
Her outfit was fantastic.
I mean, this was probably one of the more tamed weeks.
Yeah, it was.
But, I mean, where do you get a gold suit from? Like, what... It went along with Australian gold, obviously.
Don't you think if you have Australian gold, you got to go get a gold suit?
I don't think she went and got one. I'm fairly certain that was in her wardrobe, which is why it's strange. But her ensembles have been why I believe that there was creative energy in her for weeks, and she has expressed it and shown that she has a level. She deserves to be there, I think.
Yeah. She also was creative with her face.
Here's what I will say, actually. you guys say that a wardrobe can be a creative thing. I'm going to bring up Mad Men, right? Mm-hmm. And Don Draper, very conservative in the way he dresses, very conservative in the way, like, he when he left his wife in season four, his apartment was very bland. Now, why is that, AJ? Well, it is because he sees the creativity that he is putting out into the world that he doesn't need to create it his own home, onto himself. He sees it out there. Also, now, that's with LaToya Jackson, 62. I think...
of self-expression, but go on.
But that's what I'm saying. So LaToya Jackson can't create that creativity onto projects, and so she instead works the creativity onto herself.
Phil, it's true. When things are simple, it means that you're inviting creativity and opportunity into the world, according to feng shui, and when qi comes in, and it should always be running in and out. But this isn't feng shui, this is LaToya.
Oh, wow. That's rough. That's rough and unfair.
That's all I'm saying. It's unfair. Someone's apartment,
but I will say that your comments is upkeeping with the theme of the ladies' team. So then it goes right along. Okay, it's good.
Right on the bus. Just jump on a train, throw a toy on the bus.
Whatever. you guys got to love. You need to learn to love LaToya like Nene does.
I love LaToya. I think LaToya is amazing, and I think Nene, love you. Two seasons ago on Real Housewives of Atlanta, but you are a biatch,
Like
a cruel She's and a all chill. The like, oh, I have to say it like it is. Like, that's bullshit. You have a filter. You can use it. You're choosing not to, and it's going to bite you in the ass at some point.
Okay, so I would like to second that. I believe that her tirade might be the right word.
Tirade.
On her team member in the panel when they were talking to the important judges, and then off was absolutely ridiculous and
nobody
unnecessary.
Was seconding, nobody was backing her up because they know that that's going to come back to haunt your ass.
Yeah.
And then she got juvenile and started calling her Casper. Just because we all think it does not mean it needs to be said.
Well, you know.
And she's not even Casper. Michael like is Casper. That.
Well, the important thing is, like you said, she's very polite, right? LaToya's very polite. Well, LaToya took the high road. It's not like she knows any other road to take, but she did kind of say one thing that was very important. Nene was a bully. She used her size and her height.
She said her height.
Well,
I thought it was so sweet. She's so cute.
But she was right. Yeah. She actually is being a bully. And no one was going to co-sign to the bullying. If she would have made her point in a way that it was actually a point was mature and was not an attack, right, then maybe she would have got a second. But as soon as it became something other than that, no one's going to second that because everyone else in there at least knows how to behave mature when they need to.
Yeah, you know, it was so out of line. And also, obviously, Nene, LaToya really gets under her skin. So obviously, Nene is a certain type of woman and has lived a certain type of way that is so different from the way LaToya's lived. So I think it just irritates her for LaToya to just be so soft-spoken and the opposite of Nene. I think it was just like clash from the beginning.
Yeah. Well, that's unfortunate because she was a team leader, and if you're a part of the team, then you kind of have to support your team leader at least to do your task and not cause additional friction if you actually want to be successful.
They should have kept her in the koala outfit the whole time.
I think maybe putting her in the koala outfit was LaToya's leadership, a way of containing Nene. Yeah. And, you know, you say one way or the other, and when you look at why didn't she utilize the Playboy Bunny?
Playmate.
You know, a play
Playmate of the Year.
Playmate of the Year.
Bunny as well. Okay. They're bunnies too, right?
Why she didn't utilize her in a way that was appropriate for the theme, maybe it was a misstep, but in direction of everything, it was a minor misstep.
Yeah.
Right? It was a minor misstep. Now, let me just jump on the guy's side for a second. Because we're going to get into this, and we're going to say, okay, well, you know, Gary was a problem, right? Gary pulled people to the side and things like that, and then you got Mark, and, you know, Mark, well, I'll say this. If you're going to be the team leader, then you need to lead. That means you need to have some level of control. Do you agree? When his attempt to break that up, when Gary came in and pulled the actual, failed, because he failed. That's why it failed. So his attempt, he noticed it. That's great. What he did about it was not acceptable.
So
was
would
not
you
enough.
Say that when Gary like strong armed him like back up boo like in front of the client, he should have been like Gary and push Gary? Like what else was he
supposed to do? No, he's supposed to know his team. He's supposed to know exactly what's supposed to happen and instruct the team how to behave and how to react. And when something goes awry, if he needs a little help, he's got a whole team of people that he can use to break that up. He did do that. He
I
brought
was gonna say,
everyone.
Tried to chant and get him free.
Yeah, but the chanting is
like, put on a show here, guys.
He knows that this guy is a randomness. So you send three guys to run interference for him while you take these people away. There's a couple other ways, obviously. I just threw that out there. And of course, hindsight is 20/20. Mm-hmm. But still. He did not properly diffuse that situation, and he could have. So, it is partially his responsibility. But back to the lady team. So you get LaToya, and she's put together her theme. She's got the sun, she's got the sunshine, she's got the sand, about 6,000 pounds worth.
Yeah, why did she need 6,000 pounds of sand?
She's like, oh, while you're there, could you get 125 bags?
It was great because they called. She said, no, call her back just to check. Call her back. Did you really mean 6,000 pounds? Yes. Please don't forget that. Make sure not forget. Did you forget how much it weighs? I'm not a small guy, but I don't want to lift around 6,000 pounds of sand on a regular basis. But anyway, so.
Do what you got to do, though.
Okay, so now, what do you guys think about her thing? Do you think it could have been better? Would you have done something different? She's got the sand. She's got the fans. She's got the sun.
I don't think it was original at all. I mean,
what was that important word?
Safe.
There you go.
Yeah.
It was safe.
They do what's safe. I definitely would have used a koala on some level because I love koalas. Uh-huh. But I
there's
mean,
a reason why.
Something surfing.
I think it was safe, but I think that she was also smart for doing it safe because I feel like her team was so against her to begin with to have tried to do too much more. Like, she didn't have the cohesion to begin with. And when you're like the guys that went with the pirate thing, like everybody had to be on board and like really be about it. And I don't think she would have ever gotten that if she like decided to be like, I don't know what else she would have decided, but like be the koalas in the trees together and they wore tan lotion. I don't know.
I mean,
so I think that on her part, that might have been a smart decision because it was simple. Nobody had to do anything excessively complicated, and they still gave her lip. Like, well, we don't understand, whatever. Because they were talking about, we don't know what we're supposed to do anyway. Like, we're going to get there tomorrow, and we're going to look ridiculous. It's like, it's a beach scene and somebody in snow. Like, it's not complicated. So I think she maybe even saved her butt a little
bit. Well, I'm not going to say that she was strategic in the process because, you know, when she was told that it was a little bit safe, she actually said, ooh. We need to do something to be a little bit more risque.
Yeah, I was going
to
ask, what made her say that again? Because it was really funny.
When one of the judges actually mentioned that that's a little safe.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
DJ.
And so she then rethought the process, and that's when she came up with the magic the very next day, which was amazing.
Snow.
But even that
was
still
snow.
Simple. It was the same idea. It was just another scene.
Okay, but it showed variety.
I didn't even know that you had to wear sunscreen when it's snowing.
Okay, so
and
you,
she,
you
we're
learn something new every day.
Tapping a whole
that.
New different clientele.
Yeah.
Her point was good. Don't get me wrong, right? It was last minute. But what she didn't do, let's talk about her leadership skills. Communication was beyond lacking because that was one of the examples of that. If you're going to change it, right, then I came up with that last night. And she's telling everyone, well, this is what I came up with. Let's say it was absolutely brilliant. Right, but she didn't communicate it to the rest of her team. They're like, what are we doing? Right. So there's,
well, weren't they up like going to the store at that point? And that's when the communication would occur.
If you're going to make a change, a dramatic change, if you decide that's dramatic enough, sun, beach to snow. 6,000 pounds of sand to snow. Okay, but I think that's a
place.
I
think it was to accompany.
Still though, you make a change like that. You've got an entire team. You're gonna even if you're gonna say, well, you know what? It's my point. I make the calls. It's what I say.
Well, that's what she did.
That's one leadership style. You still have to communicate it.
Well, she did. Yeah, we don't know at what point. All we know is them talking smack because we obviously get an edited version of time frame and where it was at. For all we know, that van ride where they were going, they had gotten up that morning to go do. And she said, oh, we're adding snow to this. And you guys, this is what we're going to go do right now. So that was her communicating.
Well,
is she going to change it already? And we don't even know.
I was actually just going off of the conversation in the van ride when it was brought up. And they were like, I don't know. So I assume they didn't know because they were acting like they don't know. But either way, that's just one example of the bad communications in there. If you look at her process of grabbing people and assigning tasks and staying in and keeping everyone together and on task, she's just a little lacking. I don't know if it's because she just has not much experience, because I understand she's an entrepreneur in the entertainment business. I think that's her leadership experience, right? Someone mentioned
that
to me.
That's what it said. On the TV.
That's
on
her title.
Entrepreneur.
Right. So, you know, she's got, let's just say her communication could have used a little bit, could have been improved a little bit. On the guy's.
I don't know that we have legit examples of that.
Well, on the guy side, what do you think? How was the communication on the guy side?
Someone should have communicated. I think they were all really timid in communicating with Gary. I think they were immature about it. I mean, obviously, you're going to piss him off. But, like, you might as well do it earlier than later because they were all really avoiding him. They were just like, oh, put him away. Just put him away. Leave him with Lil Jon.
Yeah, that was their attempt to play it safe. They put Lil Jon in charge of him, which is very interesting. And you had a comment about that.
Well, I mean, honestly, I think Lil Jon is one of the strongest players in the competition. He really is underrated with what he brings each week. He knows the business pretty well. He knows how to handle himself, and so he has an appearance about him.
Koala, really?
That is koala. Yes.
I know. It didn't. It looked like
and then
a
had really
bear.
Large breast because of me. And I was like, oh, sorry. Go on.
I am admiring Lil Jon.
But while you are talking about Lil Jon, he made this bad call, which he said, and it seemed like the smart thing to do. But he was like, you don't want to misrepresent the client's mascot. So let's not go with the koala.
That's where I would have put on my producer hat. Okay, get the damn koala. How do we make it look like the damn other koala?
Yeah, I was going to say they could try and
Marley made actually a very good comment. She said when they're in the boardroom, they showed each one the other's project results. She said, I don't really know about the pirate theme and how that works with Australia. Right.
Yeah.
So don't get me wrong. I've been around the world enough in the Marine Corps, so it almost doesn't count. Never been to Australia. I don't know how well Australians are versed with our version of pirates. Actually, that's a very important.
Can we call Paul Ashton? Paul Ashton on the phone.
Good. Paul would know.
Paul is one of our hosts from Glee and an actor from Australia.
So yeah, you know, the guys who, the team leader, should have been considering that when he was picking his theme. The other thing was you were given specific criteria. Both teams were consistent. The ladies played it safe. The guys were out of the box. And that's been consistent every episode, right?
Yeah.
This time she said, think in the box. I think in every way.
Yeah, pretty much. And the guys actually did not follow some of the key criteria, and that was a problem. And when it comes down to whether or not it was Gary or it was Mark, and Mark is like, you know, if it was truly on the theme, wholly on the theme, then I'm the one that should go, right? Let's jump on that. What do you think?
I think
what
number one.
What do you think? Not just you, by the way, because I want to hear
her
too.
You pointed at me.
I wasn't done pointing. I was pointing in order. So
okay,
you
whatever.
And also you. I want to hear you both, and then you can chime in too. Dude,
all right.
Don't feel left out.
Now that I'm like lost my thought. I think that he. Okay, I get the whole idea of recognizing the work of your team and not feeling like it's necessarily anybody's fault as to why the project didn't win versus anybody else. But We have firm examples that you never send yourself home unless you actually want to go or you will go.
Well,
that's for one.
Mm-hmm.
For two, even if it was the pirate theme and it was his idea that, you know, they came up with and whatever, your entire team still co-signed on it and decided that that's the direction that they wanted to go. So the reality is that the pirate theme, it was your idea, yes, but it's not like somebody argued with you and you shut them down and said, no, we are absolutely going this direction. They all agreed. They decided to be on one accord and go on this project. So the reality is once you get to the boardroom, it's everybody's idea. It's everybody's theme. And everybody went with it. So you have a legitimate reason to be like, okay, well, it's not all my fault. Like, and it's okay for it to not be all your fault when you're actually working for somebody else. Like, you're not there to get money for yourself. You're there for a charity. You're trying to raise money for a charity. Stop throwing yourselves under the bus. Like, why would you do that?
Okay, so what do you think?
Yeah, I think it was just pride. I think everyone who's gone home in that, like, in the name of whatever, it's like they're taking responsibility. It's true. It's totally everybody's responsibility. That's why it's called a team. You're just a team manager, so you're managing it. But just because someone had a bad idea doesn't mean that it's just your bad idea. Like, Lil Jon had a bad idea, you know, but, like, they're not going to send him home just because he had a bad idea.
And actually, but here's the thing. At the end of the day, A, you could, because there's plenty of people in the world that get fired for the smallest, what you would assume is the smallest thing. And to be honest with you, if I had to blame this inception of an idea on anyone, I would blame it on Meatloaf, who came up with the concept of, we're going to fight cleavage with cleavage.
Well, I don't even know how that ended. I don't understand, besides, like, women in pirate costumes, how...
Because they thought What's-Her-Name was going to be
Yeah,
naked.
They thought they assumed
Hope would
be
naked, basically.
But again, like I said, you know, guys don't really need a reason to talk about cleavage. We only need an excuse.
Whatever. The
and
point
pretty much anything is an excuse.
Seems to be confirmed. Mark is an idiot.
Yeah.
Because it was still everybody's idea.
No, that's really hard. She's not an idiot. It's guy code. I understand you don't. It's guy rules. It's the code of the guys.
Well, what about Gary?
And here's the thing. Well,
Gary's
here's
a guy.
For Mark, I would have made this decision.
And the women have done the same thing. Like, oh, I can't blame anybody. Yeah. The women are the ones that have gone home for saying
we're not talking about the women. Well, we're talking about the guy who you just called an idiot.
He is an idiot.
He is not an idiot.
No, he is an idiot.
But he wasn't strategic enough. He definitely wasn't strategic. Okay, let's take your piece. You're telling me that, you know, it's for charities, right?
Well, I'm just...
Has he won?
No.
Has Gary?
Has Gary?
Yes.
Won?
Yeah.
Did he get some money for it?
Yeah. His charity already has money.
Yeah, oh, that was such BS.
So there you go.
Everyone else, like, barely kept it together.
That's right. That's bad strategy if it really is about that, right? Someone, his charity already has money. The other guy, Mark's, didn't. So if you're gonna decide and you're gonna go under the bus, you know, someone's gotta go, then you should consider that as well. It always is interesting to me is they spend so much time being together and organizing the entire project, they don't organize and manage who's gonna possibly go. I would talk to my team.
Well, the women think like that, but the men don't.
That's right. Again, that goes right back into the whole guide code thing. You know, they have a code of honor, right? The code of honor is And don't get me wrong, it's dynamic. That this particular guy code was created for these guys in that show for that group, and they're sticking with it. And so then he took responsibility. But remember, we were like, you know, what should we do? Should Gary go?
And that would have been the point I would have argued if I was Mark. Okay, so we lost this task, but the greater picture is, you know, it's a competition. And like you were saying, you know, his charity didn't win. At the end of the day, Gary is the weakest link. So I would argue that point. Like, okay, I went out on a limb. I was wrong. But if anything, we had a good day. We probably converted a lot of people to the product internationally because you obviously had all of us as celebrities there, which the girls didn't do. They chose a different route, and I'm sure they converted their people. But, you know, Gary's the weakest player. Got to go.
Yeah. But he didn't do that.
He did not.
He should have done that.
He said, I can't blame anybody. It's me.
I know. And even Donald Trump was getting mad. He was like, so you want to go home?
For this is the third time.
If I was to guess why Trump might have been a little upset, because his hand got forced.
That's the point.
Okay. He has been, he is a consistent person. In his show, he's consistent. And I don't believe, and you guys can correct me because I'm not perfect here, but I don't recall, at least in this season, anyone who said I would go home didn't get sent home, right? So, you know, even though, you know, the other leaders were kind of just throwing things at him, trying to, like, Lisa, she's a classic example way back when they were just trying to help her so bad.
And she wouldn't take it.
She would not take it. Mark actually tried to take it for a minute, but Trump was on him. Trump was like, but you said, let's go back to the thing you said, mm-hmm. but you said. And I'm not even sure if he would have waffled if it would have done him any good. He did waffle a little bit because take Gary. Some of the stuff Gary said was, and he doesn't even remember it.
Oh, I think Gary remembers it.
The thing about that, it's like I'm not sure what is reality for him. I know that my friend sent me a link to all of his like craziest interviews where he started, and everyone goes sexual. Like he's talking about like a goat, like, and how he's from Texas and how like
goats in Texas this, and sexual.
Yeah.
That's not that kind of show.
Right.
But I mean, this show isn't that kind of show.
Right. But Gary Busey's show of a human being is that kind of show. It's really messed up. And also, I know my experience with him, he said that apparently he like disregards people and like pushes them out of the way, which is exactly what he did.
Yeah, he did.
And so I think that he's crazy. He's I think he's mentally ill, but at the same time I don't want to give him the benefit of the doubt and excuse him. Because I think he also knows what he does. It's scary when he says he doesn't remember things.
Why is that scary?
Because it's like, where were you? where did you go when that happened?
He was in Gary's mind.
It's all a game, man.
Yeah, okay, so the great quote from Mark. Courtney, you have it written down.
Life advice from Mark McGrath.
He said, he told Gary Busey, you need to take a big swim in Lake
I see where that takes you.
That is going to be in my land of quotables for all eternity.
Oh, amazing.
Because, oh my God. But the worry is that Gary's actually already swimming all kinds of deep in Lake Him, that's why he's hella confused. So
true.
I don't even know. And it was funny when, I don't know who said, was it Mark 2 that said Gary has nuggets?
Yeah. And there's nebulous.
Like everyone else is great.
Everybody's great. Gary has nuggets. So the nugget should have got kicked off, but Mark McGrath, you were an idiot.
Yeah.
For not working that out.
Idiot.
He was an idiot.
He
was an idiot for making a really big mistake. He was an idiot for. I mean,
look up the complete definition of idiot to clarify. Hold on, let me.
You know, I'm thinking idiot isn't caused by one decision. I think being an idiot is a journey.
It wasn't one decision.
I'd say it's a lake.
It's a lake that Mark McGrath swam
and
in.
Mark and has not been on the journey of idiot.
And what's his name?
He did dabble in the pool of idiot. He just stepped in the puddle of idiot, if I may say. But he did not swim in the ocean
my
of idiot.
My phone says the pronunciation of idiot, and it is a noun, and it is a very stupid person.
Okay.
Mark, that was stupid. I'm sorry.
I'm glad you had to look that up to know what that was.
I just wanted to clarify.
It's very painful for me.
Mark,
okay.
Well, if I have words of advice for Mark.
You have none. He's gone. What's the point? Give him no advice.
You know what? This isn't really advice as much as... remember what Indiana Jones was told in the third movie?
Garbage.
I'm trying to make...
What about Indiana Jones?
Indiana Jones
she's
at the third...
At as well.
She's very mad. And you know what? This will help you out, too, for times like this. In Indiana Jones 3, someone said to Indy, you lost today, kid, but that doesn't mean you have to like it. So, Mark, you lost, but you don't have to like it. Words of truth.
No? Blah, 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 blah.
Okay.
He's stupid.
Maybe it's a man.
He's not stupid.
I'm sorry, my comment wasn't like the swimming in you.
In the lake of you.
Okay. If you look at everyone's behavior on the guys' team and who has done stupid things the entire time, we can kind of figure out who might be
Maybe there's confusion on what stupid means.
Oh, you're really gonna look up stupid for you.
Jesse, can we look up all like can we get like an official
Jesse has the urban dictionary version.
Let's do it the opposite
way. Lacking intelligence.
Jesse, is there I don't believe
Mark was lacking intelligence.
He was lacking in intelligence.
He had a lapse in thinking.
A lapse of judgment.
That's right.
Is that a word for someone who excessively looks up words for
wait
words?
Wait a minute. Wait. I love you, Courtney. You know I love you to death.
Oh, no.
But I really just looked up stupid in Urban Dictionary, and guess what the first definition is?
What?
Someone who has to look up stupid in in the dictionary.
Well, for the record, the researching of the word was for them, not for myself.
Oh, my God. I can't see.
Jesse, play us bumper real quick, because that's awesome.
That's hilarious.
No. There we go.
Oh my God.
Yeah, so regardless, that was for you guys' benefit, because we're quite clear of what Mark was. We both believe he was an idiot and he was stupid, but you guys were confused, so I was trying to help you.
He made an error, but
He made an error. He made a few errors.
He made a few. Yeah, he made a few. The theme pirate was fine if it does work with Australia. I don't know, but they should have put the koala bear in a pirate costume.
Yeah, but either way, I think it would have been cute. They had to use it.
It was the rules.
Been the koala. The little pirate should have been the koala.
Yeah, seriously.
I don't think the little. I would have had a koala.
He should have been a koala, and the big boobies girl should have been holding the koala. Like there should have been a koala and the girls and the breasts. It would have been amazing.
You know what? I really want to hate on her, but that's a really good freaking idea.
That is amazing.
Like it would have been awesome because we all love koalas. Like, and we all love boobs. And you love boobs, and it would have been great. Whatever. But I don't even think it's bad that they went there. I mean, I don't get it.
The koala should have been putting the lotion on the women.
It should have been a midget koala that was putting the lotion on the women's breast assists that were exposed.
No, 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 no
no. Bestiality. No, you bestiality is more.
We were giving it to
because
you.
Because
yeah.
This is AfterBuzz Television, not Phil and AJ's pornographic.
That
fantasies.
Was gonna be awesome. Because the midget, the little guy would have been covered up. And
Mark, you realize what you're saying. You're talking about midgets and koalas and rubbing on bodies and breasts. Gross. It's not okay.
You can take away everything but the rubbing on the body part. We keep the rubbing in the body. I mean, it was suntan
lotion.
See,
we tried to keep it simple. I'm like, oh, the koala can be on her hip, like holding, like
you
a
said
cute,
boobies first.
Like a teddy bear. And I said the breasts will be there. I didn't
Did
say
you say breasts or boobies?
The koala
said they have.
Was not going to be all up in the boobies. She was going to be holding the koala.
Oh, we would have
like,
got a we would have got
bear.
A nice cleavage shot. Oh, for sure.
Oh, God. Anyway, that's why y'all lost.
Yeah, seriously.
Anyway, that's all just for fun, everybody. But we did lose. Actually, we kind of got a butt kicked on that one by LaToya. So, guys, you should really consider a butt whipping by LaToya as a genuine butt whipping.
As Nene said, y'all had just fucking out all the way.
You know, and I don't think that was right. I think the safe way is sometimes the right way. And in this particular case, the safe way was the right way. Not like before when Lil Jon had running it, and we thought the safe way was probably the right way then because of the corporate types there that were involved, and actually his way kind of worked. But the guys have been consistent. This time it just kind of fell on them.
Which is fine. I think they should have went for it. They had an idea. I think they did a good job with executing the idea. If it didn't ring true for the customer, but the whole strategy around getting rid of the Gary Busey.
So here, I got one quick question. So this is a question I've been saving. I want to ask everyone and just chime in. Do you believe that if Mark would have been able to grab them as soon as they walked in, he would have been able to convince them and show them anything that would have made it a winner? You believe it was a loser from inception, or was it a loser because they weren't sold on it properly? I just want to know. And I'm asking you because I have a point afterwards. So what do you think?
I think that they didn't like the concept. Yeah, and I think pirates. That he would have done, I think they might have been less annoyed that Gary Busey bothered them and that he may have been able to communicate what they were going for. But I think that they seem like they were actually looking for something that was more in the box.
Well, they weren't looking for a Captain Morgan
piece.
I mean, Meatloaf in the meeting said, have you guys ever done pirates? No.
Okay.
And then you know what? They've never done Pirates. They, yeah, this exactly is what they're looking for. Okay. No.
And they totally missed one of the major points was like the live gold life or whatever that was. Like they didn't integrate that into their concept at all.
Yeah, so all I want to throw out to you guys is this. Lil Jon's idea was pretty radical with the commercial for the video conferencing, the video phone. And if you remember, the thing that, and that was a really close one, right? 53 to 46 or something like that. It was pretty close. And the thing that they said will probably push them over was Lil Jon's pitch. Lil Jon used keywords. He used viral, right? He used all of these words in his pitch that gave them just that little nudge. I would say, I would kind of say that this could have received a nudge like that if he would have had the opportunity. Mark was, and we're assuming he's not or he is, as good a salesperson, as good as a pitch man as Lil Jon, and he could have pitched past the shortcomings and emphasized the greatness, because there was some greatness there. That place was absolutely buzzing with people. And viral, buzzing, right? Those are important things, right?
But the difference between those two projects was that the Lil Jon project with the guy and the reason that was a little uncomfortable because it was dealing with homosexuality, but it still was like the point of the product, like was still completely and clearly communicated, and it was hysterical. So whether or not you agree with the homosexual marriage part, it was still funny. This didn't really, as Marley said, like Pirates, Australia, tan lotion.
I'm going to have to stand back on that one. I'm going to have to admit, I don't know, right? You have to know what you don't know. I don't know. And anyone out there can like send us a note on AfterBuzz. How can they let us know?
At AfterBuzzTV.com.
Let us know how Australia feels about Pirates. We don't know. I'm ignorant and I apologize for that.
I've never heard of Australian Pirates.
Really. Yeah. And they, I mean, it's not like they
were. Pirates are real.
And suntan
don't go
lotion.
Near Somalia.
Somali, I know. That's
and I've been to Somalia.
Well, you know what? You know what? They not that these guys are affiliated with Australia, but there is Paul Watson from the TV show Whale Wars, the cult leader, as I like to call him. They are out of Australia, although they operate under the Dutch flag, and they are indeed pirates who battle the Japanese whalers bombs.
Do they see them like with the winches and the boobs and the like? Swords.
That is Paul.
Like,
Paul Watson's pirates certainly do not have women
like,
and
so
breasts.
That's sort of our women and breasts. So that's still like our concept of it. And I feel like even if they did the pirates, like maybe they should have had the pirates on the boat, like tanning, like to make the winches hotter. Yeah.
We don't want to see pirates tanning unless they're
women
pirates.
No, what I'm saying is they didn't link it to the actual product at all.
Yeah, tanning. Exactly. The only relation was that pirates like gold.
Yeah, and that's not, I mean, and it's like there was no function of what the actual product is.
Like they got the boat, got everything.
Fair enough. It could have been that his pitch wouldn't have been enough of a nudge anyway.
It wouldn't have. He would have lost anyway and went home because he's
But I believe I believe the fact that he didn't get to do a pitch is significant. And the whole Gary pulling them aside and cornering them and you know, he's a very sexual guy and he wants to know. He wants you to know.
That.
Yes.
No. He didn't say
Yes.
He said it gave him sexual feelings that make him feel good about himself.
You guys, he didn't say sexual. He just said he got sexual feelings.
You know, interesting enough, didn't he?
What the hell does that even mean?
Didn't he flash us a few episodes ago?
Yeah, he did. He did for the commercial.
How do you know it was his ball sack? Were you paying that much of attention?
God, if we actually saw his balls.
and you're supposed to
there
say,
go the ratings.
You're saying it wrong. It's balls.
Oh, God, Jesse, no.
Oh, no.
He said balls.
I feel dirty.
You gotta say it on balls.
I feel dirty.
Gary's balls.
Ew, this is bad.
Gary's
balls.
Why are you
Gary
guys?
Gary Busey's balls. I'm not gonna get the feeling. She's the one that's focused on the balls.
I'm throwing up in my mouth.
Oh my God.
So inappropriate.
So awful.
I'm grossed out. Oh.
It's gonna be okay. Because you'll get a chance to see his balls
again.
Balls
are gross to begin with, but yeah, him with Gary.
For real.
Anyway, so
before we get unplugged from the network, we should really start wrapping up and go to
commercial. The only thing worse than balls is Gary Busey.
Or Gary Busey's balls.
It's not okay.
Exactly.
Wow. Well, what came first?
We had to feed it. It were hungry for it. We had to give it to him. It's okay.
Ew, no you didn't. Oh. Get out! Get us out of here!
All right, Jess,
take
commercial.
It away.
Get us to commercial ASAP.
Want
to
find out what the AfterBuzz is about?
Janice is a drama queen.
This is the divide that is going to carry the series.
Give us a call at 347-855-8269.
This television, and they want it to be as dramatic as possible.
You'll mean it's Shakespearean.
You never know what goes on behind closed doors.
Get in on the AfterBuzz.
347-855-8269. Now, in the eyes of Jimmy, Nucky is a villain.
Listen on iTunes.
I mean, who would you guys rather hear that from?
Find us on Facebook.
Your husband or your best friend?
Follow us on Twitter.
And then she's trying to kill him, so it justifies it. I'm like, oh, now it makes sense.
And visit us at AfterBuzzTV.com.
The wig will come off.
Let that wig come off, baby.
No, what?
Boardwalk Empire.
Desperate Housewives.
Glee.
Gossip Girl.
Breaking Bad.
Mad Men.
True Blood.
The Walking Dead.
Big Love.
Jersey Shore.
The Oscars.
Celebrity Rehab.
The Emmys.
If it's hot, you can bet we'll be buzzing about it.
All right, so apparently, whoa, unnecessary. Michelle just threw stuff at us. The last line of our commercial, if it's hot, we'll be buzzing about it. Apparently, the girls find A, Gary B. Why are we on this?
Gary
TV exclusive.
Gary Busey has a penis too.
It's a package.
Oh my God.
They come together.
Shut. Oh my God.
And turn this freaking song off.
That's so sick.
I'm sure Gary Busey is very excited that you ladies are talking about this topic. And I
feel
and
like
don't be surprised
reflex.
If he tries to contact you to discuss it further. Can you imagine how that conversation might
be? I'm gonna.
And right. You know he's not shy.
He's touched me.
Right. Where has he touched you, honey?
Just on the shoulder, but it was bad enough.
I am making a vow right now that I am gonna do everything I can to get Gary Busey in studio.
No.
Yes. You can make that happen. I know it.
We haven't.
Tell him about this situation.
If
yes.
my
You'll
manager
be here.
Calls him and threatens him with a lawsuit unless he comes in, we can probably do that.
I think he would come in just to talk to you alone.
Oh God.
Where's that music again?
No. And you guys would like lock the door.
It would be great. Yeah. Turn down the lights.
Turn it on.
Oh my God.
Gary Busey is so turned on.
Yeah, he's pretty excited right now.
Oh my God, seriously.
By the way, for those of you listening, this is now our special segment. This is what it is.
If we can make predictions, it's going to be about what Gary Busey's going to do and how excited he's going to get when he sees this section of the show. Can you imagine? And you know he's a wildfire. So you can't even predict what he might do. And he's going to see you two lovely ladies talking about his both.
What did you say about Dick?
Shut up!
Seriously.
Okay.
Wait, I have a better idea.
Wow.
That didn't go as far as I wanted it to go.
Because he's taking the steam out of you. That's
Shut up! Do we have a special segment, or is this a special segment?
This is a special segment.
I'm going to go throw up now.
Okay. All right, Jesse, get us to the news.
Oh, my
and,
God.
Because they're about to climax.
All right. Actor and comedian Bill Cosby knocked tycoon Donald Trump down on Thursday's edition of the Today Show during a talk about education. Cosby stunned host Meredith Vieira when she mentioned having an upcoming election and that Donald Trump had just been on the show with her. Cosby interrupted and said, "Oh, please, with Donald Trump, take him home with you because he's full of it," stunning the hostess into several seconds of silence.
Mm-hmm.
"You run or shut up, but that's the only thing he's running is his mouth."
That was
in Donald's interview with Vieira, he admitted that he has a special team in Hawaii investigating Obama's birth certificate.
It takes a special team. Turns a lot of work. I just want to say, I love Bill Cosby. He can say what he wants. Y'all can't do nothing about it. He's granddad. Your granddad can say just about anything.
Pudding and the Jello.
Yeah, exactly.
Jello and the pudding.
Jello and the pudding. You can say whatever you want. Yeah. And that's, know why she was stunned? Because she didn't know what she would say to grandpa. She knows she's just got to let her say whatever he wants.
Pretty much.
Yeah, what can she say back?
Nothing.
And Donald, whatever. I'm not even.
Obama's birth certificate?
I will not even entertain
I have a copy
that.
Of it. We all do.
all black people do. All you black folks running around need to prove that you were actually born in the United States. Because apparently everybody has to. Except the only person we know about that has to is Obama.
Yes.
Nobody believes it. Because there's no pictures of him. Remembers him.
But there's probably pictures of him in
Maybe
Africa.
Maybe he was cloned.
But he was, because he was born in Africa, and you know we just don't know that.
And he's tricking
They don't have
us.
Pictures and cameras in Africa then?
Well, the point is
they have AIDS in Africa.
You know, they don't have cameras.
So we don't go to Africa.
We call that a solid bringer downer. But
yeah.
I mean, right, Donald Trump, really, that's what you're starting off your supposed run for president with.
But he's a business tycoon genius.
He's a business tycoon asshole.
Yeah.
Okay.
He's a business.
Why don't you run on some problems or some issues or some start talking about that? Why are you still questioning whether or not this dude is from America?
Seriously, are you really think that you're gonna like get somewhere with that?
Well, while we're on the topic of elections, one of the cool things that AfterBuzz will be doing is covering the elections, because it is and here's the thing that I actually did learn from one of our political analysts, is the fact that, okay, there's 50 candidates in every election. We only know friggin' two. That's it. But by these people bringing up these issues, it forces the main candidates to be able to talk about it. And so that is one of the things we're pushing. And we'll be pushing that when we no longer have a black hole at AfterBuzz Studios. By the way, yeah. So we are redesigning the studios for the coming weeks. But for those of you wondering why our wide shot looks like there's a black hole at AfterBuzz Studios, it is not permanent. We're fixing that.
Yes, and we'll get to talk forward about to. How Donald Trump is gonna make this country better, just like Arnold Schwarzenegger did for California.
Yeah. Oh, love it.
Score
the governator.
Whatever.
I'm not paid to lead. I'm paid to lead. Just saying.
All right. Well, Star Jones has admitted that she misses engaging in stimulating discussions about the day's hottest news items with her former View co-host. The lawyer remarked, quote, "I miss the discussion. I miss the hot topics and arguing back and forth. But social media has really taken over, and I've enjoyed some of that. And then sort of running around the country, that is allowing me to get my fix, if you will."
You mean you missed the paycheck and you missed the relevance.
Yes.
Because you're fairly irrelevant other than Celebrity Apprentice right now.
Yes.
And you don't like it.
Mr. Trump's running mate?
You don't like it.
Now you're on to something.
That'd we won't start time. On politics
Ivanka
today.
Will probably be the running mate.
I would rather Ivanka be the running mate.
Yeah, me too. I'd rather her be president.
Star being president.
Hell yeah.
Ivanka or vice president.
President
or Secretary of the State,
whatever.
Star Jones.
Big boo, Star Jones. Yeah. Go back to being a lawyer.
Yeah.
Well, in other big boo news, Richard Hatch has issued an open letter to anyone who will listen, proclaiming that he's been wrongfully convicted, saying, quote, "I can prove my innocence if someone will loan me $300,000.
No.
Hatch writes in his letter, "If it takes the rest of my life, I will pay the money back to you with interest and gratitude."
Honey, you couldn't pay your taxes. How are you going to pay somebody back $300,000?
Maybe we should start like a fundraiser.
That's why. For what? He's like in jail because he didn't pay taxes.
But.
F you. I had to pay Uncle Sam last week. You're behind, had some money, and you didn't pay for
you know,
it, so go be in jail.
I think you had a few less zeros behind it.
Blah, it pay, but I still had to pay mine. That's the point. He had more zeros to pay. He should have paid it.
Yeah.
I don't want to hear about it.
Well, he's
talking about you need $300,000.
But it's a cry for help.
That's not a cry for
help.
That's
ridiculous that that's like even a quote. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, well, apparently it is.
Well, I'm
sure. People need to stop asking him what he thinks.
You know what's a great quote?
Why don't you go take a swim in a big old lake of you?
Why don't you go scuba dive?
And Gary Busey's balls.
Oh, my God.
And the maturity level continues to decrease on AfterBuzz.
Rapidly dropping.
And that's your AfterBuzz Celebrity Apprentice news for the week of April 10th, 2011.
I'm just saying, Gary Busey has.
And now, you're AfterBuzz TV.
out that's part of it until I went over.
My sound effect. Yeah. As they rub lotion.
Yeah. Hold on. I'm
Oh, we're watching Gary Busey.
Feeling the universe.
AJ is feeling the universe.
I'm feeling hungry.
At least I'm not feeling Gary Busey's balls.
Immaturity. Predictions.
Anyway, predictions besides that.
Okay, so
we get a Gary Busey-filled episode.
So we know that Gary Busey is going to be leading the group.
Yes, he is.
And so will your favorite person and mine,
who?
LaToya, on the ladies' team.
She's going to be leading again?
Yes.
Did I miss that?
You did miss that.
Yeah.
Yeah, so she's going to be leading again, and, you know, the ladies love just running over her with that bus.
Hey, I say get it, LaToya, because that just means you're about to make some more money for your charity.
Yeah, seriously.
Yeah, you think she can win, right?
I think them other hoes are haters.
You know,
Gary could surprise the hell out of us. Like, he's crazy as all crap, but...
He would only surprise us with more crazy.
But crazy could be good, and it might work for that, whatever they have as a challenge.
Yeah. That could happen.
I like how everyone basically said out loud that he's crazy in this episode, though.
Well, including Trump at this point.
Yeah, exactly. He's like
keep your hands to yourself, keep your face to yourself, keep your mouth to yourself.
See, I've always told everyone has their version of crazy, right? So all of us are a little bit crazy,
right.
But Gary Busey's crazy is a little bit crazy. That's all. He's got some crazy on his crazy. That's all I'm saying.
So he could be crazy.
He's late
creative.
Crazy.
So I predict that Gary Busey's going to show more of his crazy, less of his balls. And that the ladies team is going to be led by LaToya Jackson, and she's going to surprise everyone, and she's going to hit Nene over the head with a lawn
chair. By the way, smart choice. Gary Busey is going to be the project manager. Time to step in there because you're probably going to win.
Possibly.
LaToya is going to jack Nene up, and it's going to be a Jackson
beatdown.
She's
not going to jack her up. LaToya will only jack Nene up with her pleasant words, like, oh, Nene, you're so below me, but I'll never actually say that. I'll just smile.
Yeah, she's drinking wine.
And continue to beat your ass while I send money to my AIDS charity.
That's the truth, because, she kind of doesn't measure up. But, you know, Nene is, but if anything, I would like to say something to Nene, relax.
Please. I think Nene is selling her brand to the fullest extent.
Is her brand unnecessary hostility?
Her brand
is... Because she can keep that brand.
Her brand is, I'll tell you like it is, and I'm going to say it. I don't care what it is. And that's what she's selling. She's selling it all the way.
She called her Casper. I think that's officially black-on-black crime.
And,
I mean,
you know,
she still is black.
Is it really?
Well, kind of, sort of, for the most part.
Nonetheless.
Well, that's the... Anyone else? Who's going to win? What's the test? Do we even know the test?
We don't even know what the test is.
The guys are going to win.
No,
I have to say
the
that.
Guys are gonna lose because Lil Jon's gonna want to be like kidnapped by Ivanka because he's so stressed out being on Gary's team.
Yes, and also Gary's gonna win.
He's like, take me with you.
I know.
The guys are going down.
But the guys know how to pull together.
Going down in flames.
Regardless.
There's only what, three against Busey now?
Yeah, Busey's gonna ruin it, I think.
I think Busey's gonna find his inner sanity.
Busey is the Tasmanian devil. He's gonna be like,
no way. I think he's gonna surprise you and he's gonna pull it in and he's gonna be straight and narrow. Like he's
That's
never
why Lil
like,
John
he,
wants
like his
to go
brain
home.
Was never injured.
Alright, well, we'll see. Next week.
See.
Tune in next week for AfterBuzz as well. And make us number one on iTunes again, please.
All our shows.
We
check
like
Drag Race tomorrow. Dance with the Stars.
From producers Kevin Undergaro and Phil Svitek, engineer DJ Jesse Janity, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. If you have questions or comments, be sure to buzz us at info@AfterBuzzTV.com. And you can find us on Facebook or follow us on Twitter by searching for AfterBuzz TV.
Balls you later.
Later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.